prepared to compete. You see the focus. You feel the energy. These guys are ready to go. Soaring high above the Willamette River, towards our location tonight in downtown Portland. Joining Greg Anthony, Brett Berry, and David Aldridge, I'm Kevin Harlan. And with us tonight, the always insightful Kenny the Jet Smith. Kenny, it is so great seeing you.
Hey, Gregory Anthony, how are you today?
We're doing well, Kenny.
We are. But it's good to have another guard on our road.
It is, you know what? It just brings a whole new level of intellect to the broadcast.
Thank you. Both guards are the quarterbacks of this department.
Yeah. You want an intellect, I'm the guy to bring down from up there.
Yes.
Spell intellect for us real quick, just so we get a taste of your...
And now we're back on to LA. Let's go, ladies and gentlemen, we're on. Let's go to the game.
Hey, Dave.
Kevin, thanks. Star players move around more than ever, it seems, but guys like Damian Lillard are emulating legends like Dirk Nowitzki, who stayed put in Dallas his whole career. Dame said, I'm not loyal to a fault. I'm loyal to the person that I am. I want this city to feel what it's like winning the championship after such a long time. Kevin?
He stays working and stays true. David, thank you.
And you look at the game of C.J. McCollum. Kenny, he gives you so much at that off-guard position. A very well-rounded score.
Yes. He can hurt you in a lot of different ways. He's got the in-between game. But his game off the bounce, Kevin, like just isolation, dribble, penetration, and shot selection is probably top five in the NBA.
And he can put out that 30-40-point game, too,
without question. He's a versatile scorer.
Awesome.
And
the starting lineup for the Pelicans, Ingram the three and Zion the four. Bledsoe is out there with ball, and it's Adams in at the five. And for the Trailblazers, we've got Damian Lillard, Robert Covington out there with Ennis Kanter. Then it's Jones, and it's Trent in at the shooting guard. Shot at two there.
Great focus from Lillard after getting hit. Keeps his eye on the rim.
The drive by ball. Here's Bledsoe, and Covington sends it back. Lillard with it, all guarded by Ingram. And Lillard gets it to go. Got his second bucket of the night.
A volume shooter from deep, but Little awfully effective.
To the inside. Here's Ball, and that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
And really the defense fouling there to prevent the layup, but that's exactly what you need to do.
New Orleans shooting their first free throws tonight. The first trip to the stripe in this one.
And when you look at that free throw percentage on the season, they're right around 73%.
Ball hits them both.
Well, if you're going to perfect your shooting stroke, it's not just about the three. Sometimes it's about settling in, getting to the free throw line to get those mechanics down. Alonzo is improving.
Well, a good start here. That's Trey for Trey, and that's Spanish for three.
The NBA being so much about entertainment, Kenny. If you had to choose the best showman in the league, who would you pick?
Ooh, the best showman
with style and charisma.
Steph Curry.
Yeah, he'd be right up there with you.
LeBron is the showman, but Steph is, I think, the top of the league. Giannis is a showman, but he's like Rich, Harden, and maybe someday Zion.
I would go there as well. The one thing the one reason that I have a little concern with Steph is we haven't, those other, like, LeBron doesn't have to have a great team. You know, he can make a team great. That's the one difference with him.
I don't know. He made that team great before Kevin Durant got there.
No. Well, he's playing with a few of the Hall of Famers. My point is, if we put him out there with guys who weren't all-star caliber players, that's my concern. We've seen, I'm with you, Giannis has done that, LeBron has done that. Steph's a showman in his current existence. And Luka
is a all-time showman.
Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. This is his first free throw of the game. He was extremely sharp at the free throw line in their last outing.
Kenny, so much can happen on draft night. What was it like for you the night you were selected?
out of North Carolina, number 6 overall.
It was interesting because I wasn't sure if I was going to second.
Really?
Because I interviewed for everyone else in the top 10, basically, except for me. And they took me without an interview. And that surprised me. Not very often, Greg, in life, you get a job without an interview.
Yeah.
Well, I got that.
A high-paying job.
A high-paying one at that.
First time out of the game called for New Orleans. Moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Blazers.
In the NBA, you've got to keep pace. It's a fast track out there, and I thought their lack of hustle defensively was the story of the game.
You can't allow any opponent to shoot that kind of percentage. If you do, it's just going to be so tough to keep up.
And Robert Covington picks up the foul. That'll be his second foul of the game. And Portland making a change here. Anthony's checked in. And that was another look at the aggressive D that led to the Mobile One block.
Some intimidation right away. Got to show those shooters you're going to be there all night long.
Here's Ingram. It's good. He makes his first shot of the game. Kenny, your career saw the expansion of the NBA as the league added several new teams. How did expansion change the league and change for the players when you were on the floor?
Well, probably Greg can answer this better because he had to move out of the country when the expansion came. But the great thing was, how did that feel? Leaving the country, not just leaving the state, but leaving the country.
And that's the point. It is different. Like, I mean, obviously, it's still North America. Very close to us culturally, but it's still different. And the other big part was, you know, they knew about basketball, but it wasn't a part of their fabric. So a lot of times you were trying to educate fans to help them, you know, have interest in the game. So it was different, especially growing up as a kid. You know, I never dreamt of playing in
Zion's going to bring that to the table right there. A presence on the boards and determined to score once he gets his hands on that rock.
And that one is good. Miller.
Defensively, they just look out of sync, not closing out on the threes in time.
To the left wing, here's Williamson. It's good on the put back.
Timeout. Did you feel that one? What was that on the Richter scale? Zion with the monster dunk.
So timeout called here, the first for Portland.
Whether things are good, bad, or indifferent, coaches will have adjustments to make throughout the course of the game.
Yeah, not just there to pump up or to discipline the players. You got to make sure that the coach makes the proper adjustments and has his team in the right mindset to carry it out.
A big group substitution here for New Orleans. Hayes is checked in for Steven Adams. The Colo Valley comes in for Zion Williamson. Josh Hart, he's checked in for Ingram. And J.J. Redick is subbed in for Eric Bledsoe. Kenny, as a freshman, you joined one of the great lineups to ever play in college basketball with guys like Michael Jordan, Sam Cruz. I mean, it was a who's who of the game.
Yeah, Michael was so excited.
What
was he?
Soon
as I walked on campus, New York, he picked me up at the airport, you know, drove me around.
In your car?
Oh, yes. But it was just great. Playing there with those kind of guys, it really gets you ready and prepared.
Had you met Jordan before you
went on a visit? Just on a visit.
On a visit, you
But
had.
He wasn't the best player, really, at the time. Sam Perkins was the guy. He was a four-year All-American, first team. So it was Sam Perkins who everyone was in awe of. Plus, he was from the
Ball from long range. That's it. He's got two made now, and he's shooting 2 for 3.
Some gamesmanship now as Ball saw 1-3 go and said, I'll get one back on you.
Three-pointer, Miller. Portland.
Out of their last 5 fakes, how about all 5 from long range?
Pelicans trail by 17. And it's Ball penetrating, lays it up off the glass. Ball's got 10.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
Miller with the bucket.
12 straight points off of 3 points.
falls. He's got 12.
This is not a player who likes to be trailing in any game. That lights a fire.
Three-pointer, Lillard. Redick with the rebound. And here's Redick. He'll bring it up for New Orleans. It's a 16-point game. Last time against the Trailblazers, they lost in Portland.
And turnovers were the story for them when they saw each other last. I mean, just a heartbreaking way to lose the game.
And Lillard gets it to go.
Incredible confidence by Lillard. But when you have that kind of rage, you have a reason to be confident.
Keep attacking.
Greg, this is why they say there's no substitute for experience.
And I agree. And you know, sometimes guys need to learn to be more selfish at times. You also learn, if it ain't broke, keep going with it. Ride the hot hand.
And welcome back to the second quarter of action. Plenty of basketball left to play, but this one has been one-sided so far. And the Trailblazers have really been rolling, haven't they?
They've been relentless offensively.
Well, just taking it right at the opposition and the other team right now. No answers and no way to slow them down.
And a chance here presented by Gatorade to see who's on the floor. All fueled up and ready to go for the start of the second quarter. So the Pelican five right now. They're back. Ball and ready. Then it's Jackson Hayden. And it's Hart in at the three.
That's all about Rodney Hood and his length to get that one.
Kenny, you played alongside some incredible clutch performers. Who would you give the ball to now for a game-deciding three?
Game-deciding three. Steph Curry's number one. Klay Thompson's number two. Ray Allen's retired, so I'll go with Trae Young.
Ooh, what about Dame Lillard?
Dame Lillard, number three. And then Trae. Steph, Klay, Lillard. Game winning, three, not off the dribble.
I'm going to throw a wild card out there. Kevin and I saw him hit one of the biggest threes.
Yeah, that's a wild card.
That's a wild card. Hey, he hit a three to get to the finals.
Yeah, I'm not mad at that.
He was injured that game. Yeah,
those shoes.
And Anthony gets it to go.
I see Melo slink himself into position there, and good timing on the offensive rebound putback.
Passes it to Hart. And he banks in the layup. Hart's got five.
Can't talk enough about the subtleties in that setup right there. The assist, really the key to that entire sequence.
A nice shot by Sonnen. Kenny, your teammate Akeem Olajuwon, a lead on both ends. Who do you think is the best all-around big man in the game right now?
Well, as great as Akeem was, you know, Shaq was probably just the greatest ball handler as guys today. You know, when you think about that, like Giannis and Embiid, those two come to mind. They probably would have gave it to Shaq, but he would have had his shit.
And taking a broader look here at the year-over-year scoring trend for Eric Bledsoe.
And maybe it's shocking, maybe not too shocking, but the scoring trend over the last few years has been going down a bit. And I'm sure it's something he's well aware of, and we'll see if that continues
Trailblazers making a change here. Trent's checked in. And then for New Orleans, Adams, he's checked in for Jackson Hayes. Williamson comes in for Nicolo Melling. And it's Ingram in for J.J. Redick. Here's Simons. And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact. The Trailblazers shoot their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game. The first one falls. Kenny, you play for a number of coaches in your career. Which players right now do you think, if you take a look at all the players in the league, would maybe make a good head coach in the future?
Well, LeBron would be a great coach. CP3 would be a heck of a coach. CJ McCollum plays the game because he's a guy. I like guys who weren't like the star and then became it because they understand the guys on the bench, how they feel, as well as the stars. So CJ McCollum has got to come up in that.
That's why a lot of great coaches, it's not that they were the best player, but they played on a great team. So they get to see it. I throw another name up there, Rajon Rondo.
What about
shooting their fifth and six free throws of the game. That free throw missing. So he comes up empty at the line.
And they're really getting more points at the free throw line here in the second quarter.
Portland leading by 19. Fast break here from the Trailblazers. Takes the three. That one's in. His first bucket of the game. He's one for two.
And that's back-to-back threes. But he just seems to be slacking off a little bit.
Right wing. Bledsoe outside. And they pick up two.
Timeout.
Bledsoe's got seven.
I don't know what's happening defensively, but they're not putting up any resistance.
Now a timeout called by Portland. They defeated the Pelicans in their last game.
Me, guys, that's what I call a character game. I mean, they could have closed up shop. It would have been easy to just let that one go and get ready for the next one, but they fought back. I mean, and that mental fortitude that they displayed there is one of the reasons why they're such a good team.
The Pelicans making a switch here. Ball's checked in. Let's take this chance to showcase the top setup man at the small forward position in the NBA. Brandon Ingram, fourth.
And these are some of the best teammates ever going to want. Very unselfish players at a position where you don't see a lot of offensive facilitating.
We've seen a lot of three men be great scorers over the past couple years, but these guys fit right in the category of being some of the best passers. Almost point guard-like skills. Chris Paul movement is never an issue with any of them on the floor.
Where they're getting a lot of their points outside the paint. Three of their last five baskets are from three-point range.
The shot by Bledsoe, nobody around. That's good, and it's Ingram with the assist.
Disappointing as a player to have such a great game and still be trailing. Not over yet, though.
Two open that time, made it look too easy. Simons has got his third bucket of the night. And what about our special guest? Kenny, thanks for taking the time to join us, dropping by. Always a pleasure. You add so much to the broadcast.
Man, thanks for having me. This was just great.
Thank you. And Greg, a lot of fun to be joined by Kenny the Jet. As brilliant as he was on the court, he is just as amazing off it.
And you know, Kenny has this amazing knack for describing what he sees with such clarity. Rare gift, and I'm glad he could share it with us.
A different look now for Portland. Enes Kanter comes in for Carmelo Anthony. And Lillard subbed in for Anfernee Simons. Now here's Bledsoe. 10 points for him.
Well, I like it when he goes vertical, but I like it when he stays there. How about Zion getting up?
Lillard from outside. Come in, come in, from distance.
And what a fireworks display he's shown us tonight. Just keeps knocking it down from deep.
Craig, he has just exploded from beyond the arc. That last make tying him for second in most threes in a game. And that one's good, Ingram.
And of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is just smash mouth physical basketball, guys.
New Orleans has gone to the three-pointer 11 times tonight, nailed five of them. Ball. kick out to Adams. Ingram against Jones.
Well, Steven Adams has more skills than just being a screen setter out there, showing them off there.
Lillard from outside. Pelicans with the rebound. And a fast break now for the Pelicans. Ball with a wide open look. Off target with his three. Lillard left side. And again for three. There it is.
A shot that puts him at the top of the record book.
Well, Greg, he's now tied for the mark for most threes in a single game. In one word, amazing. And so it's the Portland Trail Blazers, holding a very comfortable 25-point lead as the quarter comes to a close. From the field, they have been outstanding, amazing shooting. That's what has them headed to a blowout. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Carmelo, you got some real numbers off the bench in the first half. How important is that contribution to the team?
Well, I mean, we always believe that we have one of the better bench in the NBA. And when they come to play like we're playing so far, you know, it makes it a tough game, makes it a tough team to beat. I'm just hoping we can keep that up.
I'm sure it puts confidence in you and in the coach going into the second half. Thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, Dave, thank you. And time now for the halftime break with the third quarter soon to follow right here on 2K Sports.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, welcome back. It is bedlam here. The hometown crowd loving that first half. I'm Ernie Johnson along with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. And returning from his sojourn, doing some in-game analysis. Laughed, cried, turned down the volume. Ladies and gentlemen, Kenny Smith.
Yeah, welcome back, buddy. Kenny, man, we missed you.
Yeah. Like how that's not a lot.
No.
They treated me so well now.
How about zero?
So hurt. And that's gonna do it for our halftime show, sadly. Third quarter about to start. See you again after the final
horn.
Oh, buzzer.
Well, we've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. Really an incredible game from Lillard.
Really impressed with the shot selection through the first half, just taking what he can get from the defense.
Yeah, I'm thinking back to the first half, and I'm wondering, did he take a low percentage shot? Everything efficient.
And with a big gap on the scoreboard, the second half begins with very different goals for these teams. One side trying to mount a comeback, one side trying to protect their lead. Good! GA in a night that everyone will remember for the rest of their lives.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. Four of their last five makes are from beyond the arc.
Here's Ball, and Ball slams it in.
The question is right now, will Lonzo Ball stay this aggressive because he's off to such a great start?
This one for three, another bucket.
And this game has his name written all over it.
Greg, he's been phenomenal in offensive onslaught. Here's Ingram. And slam dunk by Ingram.
Man, these Kevin Durant comparisons are starting to come to fruition right here, especially when Ingram is finishing with power on the drive.
And listen to this crowd. They are letting him hear it.
Greg, as well they should. One of the great three-point shooting displays we've seen in league history.
And this shooting display could be in a museum, an absolute masterpiece from deep.
Let's see the stat sheet here for Robert Covington. Since the All-Star break, he's been putting in work, getting around 12 points a game, 6 rebounds, and 2 assists. And he's done his share of the work for the team, definitely making an impact.
Well, the numbers, if you look at them, they tell blocks it all the way around and is not letting the team down.
They are on fire right now. That's four straight mates.
Well, you look at the career that Dame Lillard has had so far. Taken sixth in the 2012 draft out of Weber State, a small school, but this guy became a franchise player immediately for the Blazers.
No doubt about it, he has done a ton to help his team, but he's going to have to do even more if they want to have a chance to get back in this game.
Basket by Lillard.
Yeah, great outside shooting, really fueling this.
And so it's Williamson who brings up the ball for the Pelicans. And thinking of Lillard, the numbers over his career are incredible.
And Lillard found his strength as a shooter. And boy, did he exploit it. He's been averaging 20 points per game almost his entire career. And he's kept adding to his game as one of the elite players in our league.
Lillard from outside. And again, it's the Trailblazers from deep.
Belongs to him, and that's how you do it when you're out in front. Don't play it safe. Keep that momentum going.
And Lillard is going to pick up the foul. That'll be his second foul of the game. Some changes for New Orleans. Jackson Hayes, he's checked in for Adams. Nicolo Melli comes in for Zion Williamson. And Hart subbed in for Eric Bledsoe. As to Ingram. Wide open. Back shot, no good. Now the Trailblazers take it the other way. Following this one, they get to host the Mavericks. That'll be the middle game number five and their longest homestand of the year.
Heads up play by Rodney Hood.
For New Orleans, they've gone 4-6 from the field since the start of the third. And stolen by Hood. And here they go. Here's Lillard. And he goes big with the dunk right over Lonzo Ball.
Another reminder that Damian Lillard can be explosive. And we love
him. Here's Ball. He's got 14. Pass to Melli. Back to Ball. They need this. That's the sixth make from the field. He's taken 9 shots and missed but 3.
And aggressiveness from Lonzo showing that he's getting better and better at these quick offensive decisions.
And it's Lillard missing. New Orleans gone past the three-point line for 13 of their shots. 6 of 13. Here's Melli. That's good, and it's Ingram with the assist. Melly's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for 3. Lillard from outside. He got it again. Sensational. 71 points and no end in sight.
Young fella is in the zone. The defense right now looks helpless.
Inside, here's Ingram. Got it. Number 7 on the night. 7 for 11 from the floor.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Closing in on third place all time in scoring.
And Will Chamberlain holds both the first and third place scoring marks. First, of course, for 100 points, and third place all time with 78. Anytime Wilt's name comes up, you are making history.
Good on the triple.
They've given up a lot of three-pointers here today.
The Pelicans have gone 8-10 shooting here in the second half. Very strong. And Lillard is going to pick up a foul. And that'll be his third foul so far. J.J. Redick's checked in for New Orleans. 1:25 left here in the third quarter.
And one of the more unsung players included in the Anthony Davis trade, Josh Hart just continues to impress when given the opportunity.
A very much high-character, hard-working player. A lot more substance to his game. I also think it's interesting that in that deal, he came along with Lonzo Ball. So the two of them together accepting this new opportunity.
Again, what an avalanche!
And that score moving him clear into third all time for scoring in a game.
Well, G.A., you just knew it was a matter of time the way he's been playing. I'm sure he's not finished either.
Well, he has already cleared Will Chamberlain's 78 points. Next up is Kobe's 81. And if he passes that mark, the basketball world is going to be talking about this guy for years.
And it's out of bounds. The Trailblazers able to retain possession here. Little, he's checked in for Anfernee Simons. New Orleans also making some changes. Steven Adams comes in for Jackson Hayes. And got it! Another basket!
And if he is ripping through this defense and continues his assault on the record books.
That score moving him clearly into second place for most points in a game.
To think that he has eclipsed Kobe's mark of 81 and now has his sights set on 100. This is a game you'll be talking about for decades.
It's good from long range.
A lot of nice work now from the field. He's helped get them this lead, and now he's helped them keep it.
5 seconds.
Oh! Can't take no for granted on defense. That time with the active hands to help come away with the steal.
And so it's Ingram who brings up the ball for the New Orleans Pelicans. And here we go with Anthony, running it up the court. Another one goes. Incredible.
90. A legendary performance.
We'll be talking about this one, Greg, for a long, long time. Ingram, wide open. Good from the moment it left his hand. That makes him 10 for 14.
Ingram staying agile, ready to take the shot as soon as that opened up for him.
Lillard fires away from way outside. And another three for Portland.
It's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
And pretty infectious right here, guys. In good spirits and percentages from downtown on the rise in the second half.
And so it's Portland with a huge lead at the break. Safe to say there's no catching them today. The three-point shooting has come fast and furious to the tune of what has become a big-time blowout in progress. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here. Let's take this opportunity now to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
And I like the fact we get to see this pass one more time. A magnificent feed. And you love to see your off guard taking over the playmaking duties with this much skill.
Sometimes that's what can separate some of the best players. Not just creating for yourself, but creating for others as well.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. The Pelicans shoot so well, the offensive execution has been brilliant. 66% from the field. On the court for the Pelicans, getting the fourth quarter going. Redigan Ingram fill out the perimeter. Hernan Gomez out there with Williamson. For the three. And another one falls. Amazing. He's been absolutely ridiculous in this game.
You get the sense he just can't miss.
Here's Williamson. Well-timed pass, and he goes straight to the bucket for the layup.
Well, this is when Zion's at his best. He gets to the interior, can use that quickness and explosiveness.
Prager, the all-time assist leader for the Big West Conference. And that three, talked about some of the traits that make for a good origin, a good point guard, a good facilitator.
Yeah, I mean, listen, you have to.
Good! There's another. For so long, thought to be untouchable. He continues to amaze.
And Will Chamberlain's 100-point game has been surpassed. Pick up the phone, let everybody know something special has happened here tonight.
Trailblazers making a switch here. Trent's checked in. There's the steal. All alone, rips down the breakaway slam.
Yeah, letting it rip. They're just having fun right now.
Yeah, some of these nights you gotta enjoy yourself. Not too much at the expense of the other team, but right now this team is balling.
Here are the Pelicans with the ball. That'll be the last game of their very short three-game road tour. Covington with the steal. Trent gets the bucket.
Another turnover there leading to a basket.
Trent's gotten everything to drop so far, shooting 4 of 4. Here's Alexander Walker.
Yeah, I love the communication and the chemistry between those teammates.
And Portland with the ball. They're on a 12-4 run. A three-pointer off the mark. The Pelicans have gotten all three of their shots to drop here in the fourth quarter. They came out of the break on a roll. Controls the rebound and puts it back up and in. Ernie Gomez has got his first 2 points.
Well, beating everybody to the ball, Willie doesn't always get his number called, so he's got to put in the extra work and find these efforts on the offensive line.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
With some arc, and Covington sends it back. Shot from free throw range. A putback. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
Yeah, that's the third bucket in a row from the paint. This defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
For those just joining us, fourth quarter here. We're just over 2.5 minutes into it. We know the NBA is looking to get rid of the one-and-done rule pretty soon. Adam Silver, Greg, saying he thinks the league can create a better system. Do you think so?
I think they can create a better system for some. I think the Wilson regime, no doubt, is instrumental in that new system. Now these young rookies can get the playing time in lower-tier pro games as they continue to develop. But I think still the collegiate game plays a significant role. The experience of going to college, even for a year, can be invaluable.
There are pros both ways, college or the G League. Agree?
I do. I'm just glad it's not a one-size-fits-all proposition. Now you have the option. Not every kid wants to go to college and have that experience. Yeah, just a fantastic job to stay with the play and just not give up. Excellent effort on the offensive backboard.
Here's Alexander Walker. Poked away and stolen by Little. Gabriel with the rebound. The Pelicans have gotten 4 of 6 shots to fall so far here in the fourth. A pretty nice efficiency there. Second shot opportunity. Misses from short range.
Yikes. Bad miss. He can be more assertive as a finisher inside. It would be so much more effective.
The Pelicans shooting it well here in the fourth quarter. 50%. And it's blocked. And that's out of bounds. New Orleans will retain possession. So here is New Orleans. Hayes, no good. Here's the Trailblazers with the ball. They're on an 18-7 run. Hood for three. Drills it from outside.
Well, and this has been their strategy throughout the fourth period. We'll see how it pans out.
It's one thing to have teams shoot a bunch of threes, but with this team being that hot defensively, you gotta chase them away from anywhere near that line.
And Matador defense, that's one of the easiest shots he is ever going to see.
Yeah, feels like Christmas right now, just gift wrapping points.
Hernan Gomez is checked in for Jackson Hayes. .149 left in the game. Wentz tipped. Fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. And he makes the first. Good on both. Well, for New Orleans, shooting a tremendous 61% from the floor, hitting at all cylinders. The pass to Hernan Gomez makes it off the glass.
And one team is just completely outclassing the other tonight. Spirited performance, and it really ignited what is turning out to be a monster win here for the Trailblazers.
You don't see this kind of a blowout often. But tonight, this is a quality win across the board to deliver out this kind of punishment.
They definitely never changed the approach. They just kept after it and showed they were clearly the better team in just about every single category.
And so this is going to end up as victory number 24 on the year.
And they've really had a dominant run of games against this opponent this year. They played them three times and won every one.
And you know, when you look at the huge impact he had, just a monster game for Lou Lillard.
It looked like a couple times they might be wearing him down, but not the case. At the offensive end, he was just devastating.
He might be small for a center, but boy, can he jump out of the building.
Stolen by Cantor. Pelicans pull it in.
I don't think the defense does enough out there to bother him. I think that one's all on him. Just a flat-out miss.
Gabriel, and the Pelicans miss again. They are enjoying a commanding lead.
And it really gives them the opportunity to give their starters a rest. Always critical when you get ready for that home stretch.
An impressive job by the players, coaches, and don't discount the impact of these fans.
Awesome to see their output tonight, trying to urge their team on. That can always help. That home advantage of home fans getting you going, fully on display here. His touch from mid-range, that's almost always good. That won't shake his confidence.
Changing ends quickly, he's rewarded with a high percentage look.
Yeah, the defense trying to do their best to slow him down, but when he gets room like that, you gotta look out.
No good there. And here are the Pelicans now. Elbow shot is on the way. No good that time. Here's Cantor. And the basket is good.
Long arms and solid athleticism. Cantor with good physical tools to score in traffic.
And so Portland takes this one, but by a big margin. This game may not have been the most exciting we've ever seen, but you have to appreciate just what a critical performance they put on.
I know their fans appreciated it. And we saw at times just stretches of excellent defense. Potency from an offensive standpoint as well. They were pretty much dominant.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. Damian, it looks like this team's progress can be measured by your improvement at the defensive end. Did we see that tonight?
We made some mistakes, like every other basketball team does, but I think we did a great job of making adjustments. You know, we got a little more physical. We did a great job of that.
And that led to a big win, Damian. Thanks for your time, man. Kevin?
All right, David. Great job. Thanks so much. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Greg Anthony, Brett Berry, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA, presented by 2K Sports. So long, everyone.